Hello, my dear students. I hope you regularly watch the videos based on our subject. This is the sixth lecture related with the subject. And in our previous subject, we have completed the finding of Boolean function from the given logic diagram. Let us begin with our today's session. The first question of our today's session is question number 9. Explain axioms or postulates. It may ask in the definition that you need to define what is postulate, explain axiom. It is in the 2 mark. Now see, in the Boolean algebra, axioms or postulates are the logical expressions that are accepted without any proof. See, certain rules are there which you need to accept. There is no specific proof for the rules, right? Say for example, 2 plus 3 equals to 5. So that is a postulate or axioms only. Why? Because we have accepted that 2 plus 3 answer would be 5. There is no proof regarding such. So in the Boolean algebra also, there are certain postulates which is predefined, which does not contain any proof. There is no proof related with the logical set of expression. So you do not require to have any proof, you just need to use it, right? A set of useful theorems can be built upon it. That means using postulates, you are able to develop or build theorem using that type of postulates. And basically, these axioms are defined using 3 basic logic gates, like AND, OR, and NOT. You people know that there are 3 types of logic gates. Number 1, basic logic gate. Number 2, universal logic gate. And number 3, exclusive logic gate, right? So basic logic gate means what? AND, OR, and NOT, right? So you can use axioms in this basic logic gate. Let me repeat these 3 points. In Boolean algebra or in Boolean expression, you have certain types of postulates or axioms which represents logical expression. You just need to use that expression, and it does not contain any proof. There is no proof regarding postulates, and this postulates is made of 3 basic logic block, logic operations or logic gates, that is AND, OR, and NOT. So this particular, using this particular postulates or axioms, it can be used for the building of different kinds of theorems. So this is the definition related with the postulate. Next is called the theorem related to the postulates. Once again, I want to repeat the definition of postulate. There are certain equations which you need to accept without any proof. Over here in front of you, we have one table which is in the 3 column. The first column contains the name of different types of law. Second column represents AND gate or law. And third column represents OR gate or law. Now see, we have 11 different types of law. First law is called null law, null, right? Now यू पीपल नो दैट इन एंड लो और इन एंड गेट इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय मल्टीप्लीकेशन साइन एंड और गेट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय प्लस साइन. सो दिस पर्टिक्युलर law is based on the multiplication and this law is based on the addition. Now null law, any variable name you can take over here. I have taken x, so when in your boolean expression if you have x dot 0, at that time that value can be replaced by the zero and that law is referred as a null law. I want to repeat this line once again, that if in your boolean algebra you have the value like the name of variable, over here I have taken x, it may be a, it may be b or any other variable. So if x dot 0 is there or x multiplied by 0 is there, at that time instead of x multiplied by 0 you can write the value 0. Similarly, when there is OR gate, at that time what happens? X plus 0. So whenever there is a value like x plus 0, that value can be returned as x. Next law is called identity law. When you perform multiplication with 1, at that time it will return the same value. Say for example, if I multiplied 9 by 1, so what will be the answer? It is 9 only. So over here the same thing happens. If you multiply any number with the 1, it will be the value of x itself. So in future when any boolean algebra is there and it contains x multiplied by 1 or any variable name multiplied by 1, that value can be replaced by the x. Now in the OR law, x plus 1, so whenever any variable value is x plus 1, that can be replaced by 1. Now see, question may raised that this, how these values will come. So remember one thing, that we are learning the theorem based on the postulates, and postulates is nothing but it is a ready-made set of rules which you need to follow. There is no any proof regarding such. Right, so that thing you need to keep in mind, that why x multiplied by 1 equals to x, there is no any proof regarding that. Is that clear to everyone? Next is called ID importance law. ID importance law means x into x equals to x and x plus x equals to x. This thing we have already learned in our previous videos. I have told you that this is the boolean algebra. So in boolean expression, x multiplied by x equals to x and x plus x equals to x. If there is a simple function, at that time value would be x square over here and 2x over here. Why? Because it is normal function. So in normal function there is a infinite value, but over here we have boolean function. So boolean function, x into x equals to x and x plus x equals to x. Complementation law, there are two types of complementation law. One, x dot x dash, that means if any number, say for example 0, so what is the opposite of 0? 1. So 0 multiplied by 1 will return 0. Yes or no? See, say for example the value of variable x is 0, At that time, what is the value of x dash? It is naturally 1. So 0 multiplied by 1 will return 0. Similarly, the value of x is 0 plus value of x dash is naturally 1. So 0 plus 1 will return 1. These are the postulates which you need to mug up. This is the most IMP concept. So be careful. You need to understand this properly. You need to mug up, prepare properly. Otherwise, in future, our equations are based on the postulates. We are going to simplify the Boolean function using postulates. So if you do not remember postulates properly, at that time you are not able to convert the Boolean function, or you are not able to simplify the Boolean function. So be careful, prepare well, mug up properly, so that you can find the solutions. Next is called complementation law. X dash into dash. So x dash and whole dash. So dash dash will be removed and it becomes value itself. Say for example, the value of x dash is 0. So what is the complement of 0? Naturally 1. Right, so it will return x dash dash equals to x. So when there is a chance that a dash into bracket whole dash, so value would be of a only, and there is no law for the OR law because this is a single variable, right? So these both are referred as a complementation law. Next is called cumulative law. Cumulative law means what? X into y is the same as y into x. If I write 2 into 3 or I write 3 into 2, both are equal. Yes or no? If I write 2 into 3 or I write 3 into 2, both are equal. Similarly, in the OR gate, if I write 2 plus 3, which is equal to 3 plus 2. So that type of law is known as cumulative law. That means the name of variable, the sequence of name of variable doesn't matter. You can write xy or you can write yx. Similarly, x plus y is same as y plus x. So that law is referred as a cumulative law. Now next law is associative law. Associative means what? It is a connective law, right? The variables are connected together. Now see, over here x multiplied by y, z. So all the three variable contains equal law, that is addition law, right? End law. End means what? Multiplication. So all the three variable contains multiplication only. So if I write x into bracket yz or I write xy into z, both are equal. Similarly, if I write x plus y plus z, that is in the bracket, or I perform addition of x and y first and then I add the value of z later on, so both will return the same result. Say for example, the value of x is 5, the value of y is 5 and value of z is 2. So in this case, 5 plus 2 means 7, 7 plus 5 equals to 12. So the output is 12 in this case. Now consider this, 5 plus 5, that is 10, and the value of z is 2. So 10 plus 2 equals to 12. So both contains equal answer. Similarly, in this case also, say for example, value of x is 1, y is 2 and z is 3. So first of all, bracket goes the higher priority. So 2 multiplied by 3 returns 6. 6 multiplied by 1 returns 6. In this case, what happens? 1 multiplied by 2 will return 2, and value of z is 3. So 2 multiplied by 3 is 6. So both contains equal value. So when there is a associative law, that means it contains equal importance. If you make a bracket with yz, that is okay. If you make a bracket with the x and y, that is again okay. With OR law, you just need to use plus sign instead of multiplication sign, which will again produce the same result like the AND law. Next is called distributive law. Distributive law means what? X multiplied by y plus z is similar to the xy plus xz. That means we perform multiplication with y and again multiplication with z. So xy plus xz, which is similar to the x plus yz. How it is represented? X plus y, x plus z. So both are equal. See, let me repeat this point once again. X into bracket y plus z can be represented by xy plus xz. First of all, you need to perform multiplication with first value. Again, you need to perform multiplication with the second value. And there is a plus sign in between. Similarly, over here, if you want to make a separation of this value, you just need to write x plus y into bracket x plus z. So both are the similar law, and such type of law is known as distributive law. Next is called absorption law. Absorption law means what? If there is a two term and both contains same variable name like this x, right? So x plus x into y will return the value x. How it returns, let me tell you. See, in this particular equation, x is common in both the term. So let me take a common x before, and into bracket, follow my cursor, into bracket 1 plus y is there, yes or no? X would be common in this case. And into bracket 1 plus y remains as it is. Now see, 1 plus y. 1 plus y is similar to x plus 1. Variable name would be anything. So instead of x plus 1, what I can replace? 1. So x is common and multiplied by 1. So x multiplied by 1 returns x. So over here you will get value of x. Right now, I have just given the simple example how x will be there. But those people, some people might have not cleared whatever the thing I have delivered from here. For that people, you just need to refer the following proofs in your book, right? So over here, let me repeat absorption law once again. You can take x as a common factor, into bracket 1 plus y is there. 1 plus y is similar to variable name plus 1. So instead of 1 plus y, you can write 1. So x is a common factor, into bracket you need to write 1. So x multiplied by 1 would be x. So output would be x. Similarly, over here, we have x into bracket x plus y, which is similar to the x. So in future, if in the Boolean function you have formula like x into bracket x plus y, which is similar to the x, that means instead of this you can only write x variable name. And the last theorem related to postulate is De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law contains two type of theorem. One is called xy whole dash is equal to x dash plus y dash, and second law is related with the OR law, in that x plus y whole dash is represented by x dash into y dash. If you properly observed at that time when you open this bracket, at that time it apply dash to individual variable, and instead of AND gate it is converted into OR gate. It is a reverse operation performed over here. Say for example, x plus y, so plus is a OR gate, in that whole dash is there, so to remove bracket you need to apply dash to both variable, and instead of plus you need to write multiplication sign over here. So this is the explanation about the theorem related to the postulate. Postulate is nothing but it is a type of theorem for which you do not require to have any proof. These all are the name of law, AND law and OR law. You just need to directly write the values to perform the simplification. Now see, this is the truth table which we have already seen during the logic gates, that in AND operation 0 into 0 returns 0, 0 into 1 returns 0, 1 into 0 returns 0, 1 into 1 returns 1. This is the truth table of logic gates only, right? AND gate truth table. This is a OR gate truth table, and in NOT operations 0 equals to 1, 0 dash equals to 1, 1 dash equals to 0. AND operation is represented by dot, and OR operation is represented by plus. Let me repeat this for those people who do not understand the truth table of gates. You just need to refer the truth table of gates. This is the input values 00011011. In between that I have placed the sign multiplication, right? With the OR operation I have used sign plus. In the truth table, output is only high when both the input signal are high. In OR operation, output is only 0 if both the input signal are low. In the rest of the cases, it will be 1. And with NOT operation, 0 is replaced by 1 and 1 is replaced by 0. Over here, I have placed one NOT, that for any proof of this particular theorem, you just need to refer the page number 1.20. Approximately from the Bharat publication in the first edition, right? So if you want to see the proof of related with this particular theorem, for such you need to refer Bharat publication book. In our next session we will continue with the De Morgan's theorem. This is the most IMP questions based on the theory exam. Till there, I hope whatever the postulates I have explained over here, you need to write in the book and you need to make the practice of the particular postulates. In future, we will perform different types of operations, different types of simplification of function based on the given postulates. So this is the most IMP table which you need to mug up. I will ask to anyone when college opens. Thank you all.